The McAlpin locks and dam play a crucial role in helping vessels down the Ohio River. But what else do they do?
In this week's Ask Carrie, morning anchor Carrie Grace goes to the Visitor Center to learn more about how it works.
We just experienced a top 10 flooding event on the Ohio. As the water spilled out of its banks, the McAlpin locks were impassable. This week's question is, how do the McAlpin locks and dam work? The Ohio River runs from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania to its mouth on the Mississippi River in Illinois, and along the way, the McAlpin locks are a critical stop for vessels.
There are seven locks and dams in our area on the Ohio River. Some of them, they have the dam portion goes across the river, and if it gets too high, the barge can't actually go over that. But this part of the river, it's basically you got to come through this lock chamber, and if it gets too high, they have to close navigation off because they can't lock through.
And that's what happened a few weeks ago during the historic April flooding. We talked to Adam Conley. He is the Water Resources Section Chief for the Louisville Army Corps of Engineers. He explained how the flooding made the river levels too high for vessels to pass, making them wait for days to get downstream. Now, before the locks were built, the low water slope made that part of the Ohio impassable by vessels, except when the river was high.
There's hundreds of millions of dollars of commerce to go up and down the Ohio River. So, you know, this is a key component in making sure all that gets transported.
The McAlpin Dam, which is hydroelectric, is actually owned and operated by Louisville Gas and Electric, or LG&E, and it helps generate electricity. Some people think it controls flooding on the Ohio, but Conley explains how flooding is actually controlled.
There are about 80 flood control dams, flood risk management dams that help hold back water during, you know, high water periods. And so, you know, those were all constructed and designed to help reduce flooding kind of on the downstream areas, the main rivers, and then on the Ohio. And so, you know, those all work in tandem during big flood periods to try to reduce flood damages, reduce flood impacts to folks. Yes, we still got flooded, but if those hadn't been there, things could have been a lot worse.
And remember, if you have a question for me, you can always email me at askcarrie@hearst.com.